and welcome to Traveling Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, also known as Dash N. Well, we've covered a lot of ground in the last few episodes, so today we're going to do a little bit of a review and go back over some of the dialogues that we've seen in the last few lessons. I have with me in studio today two foreign students that are living and studying in Beijing. Thanks very much for coming to the studio. And maybe we'll start with a little self-introduction. Could you tell us who you are and where you're from?
你好，我叫村田遥，我来自日本。我是去年的八月份来到北京，现在有八个月左右。
From Japan, and you've been living in Beijing for about 9 months then.
对。
Okay, and your classmate?
我叫康云峰，健康的康，云彩的云，山峰的峰。我来自德国柏林，我也是去年九月份来到北京的。
Okay, 康云峰 from Berlin.So one of the topics that we were talking about in our previous lesson was checking into a hotel, probably one of the experiences people have on their first day in China. How about you? Any, you ever had any trouble checking into a hotel? Do you find that people speak English in hotels?
对，在中国宾馆办理入住手续真很麻烦，因为宾馆的服务员一般没有那么高的英语水平。所以我们交流的时候有很多障碍。
So you have to speak Chinese with them because they don't speak English very well.
对呀，而且这样一来会发生很多误会。比如说我填表格的时候，我一般用繁体字写，然后服务员一般看不懂繁体字。而且呢，我写康的时候，我的姓是吧，康。他们以为是唐，唐代的唐。
唐代的唐 ,okay, because you learned Chinese, I guess, originally overseas, so you're learning the classical characters.
对, 对。
But most of the people at hotels, most of the people in China would recognize the simplified characters.
对。
But you know, if they don't recognize your name, that's a real advantage when you check out, because you can just say, I'm Kang Yunfeng, and that should be Tang Yunfeng, send the bill to him.
对。
Well, how about you checking into hotels then? If you have to speak Chinese, do you find that you have enough vocabulary to handle that?
我当时词汇量还不多，所以有的个别的，比如说注册，我听不懂，所以比较麻烦。
Oh, 注册 ,what does 注册 mean? 注册 means to register. So I guess you learned that by now, eh?
对。
Okay. Well, we're going to go back now and take a look at one of the dialogues where our family, Huan Renhao and his family, was checking into a hotel and see how they manage it. Okay? Let's take a look.
我们要办理入住，
请问预订房间了吗？
啊，预订了。
您说一下姓名。
黄仁豪，美国纽约来的。
您预订了两个房间，一个双人间，一个单间。
对。
请给我看一下你们的护照。谢谢。麻烦您再填一下入住登记单。请交一下预付款。
能刷卡吗？
可以的。好的，谢谢。这是你们的房卡，两间房，一个是1183，一个是1179。
在几层？
都在11层。
那个双人间是朝南的吗？
1183不是。朝西，
能不能把双人间换成朝南的呢？我喜欢朝南的房间。
对，我们在这里要住一个星期左右，请帮我们换一下。
我查一查有没有空房间。还有一间，不过不是在11层。
没关系，在几层？
9层，918房。
我就要918房间。
You know, after today's program, you can tell everyone that you've been on Chinese television, but what about watching TV in China? Did you watch a lot of TV when you first arrived in China?
对，中国电视很好玩。我第一次来到北京的时候，我还没有那么多朋友，我有点寂寞，所以我天天独来独往看电视。
So what kind of programs do you usually like to watch?
我喜欢电视剧，因为有很多帅哥和美女说很标准的普通话。
Okay, 电视剧 would be TV dramas. 帅哥 handsome men and 美女 beautiful women.
对。
Okay, and how about you? What kind of programs do you like to watch on Chinese TV?
我非常喜欢看广告，因为广告，它说的比较直接，比如说好吃的东西就说好吃， 还有比如说牙膏就是说很健康、
okay.
觉得很好玩
I guess if you like to watch the advertising the advantage too is that you get to see a new program every 30 seconds changes quite quickly and another thing is that the two of you get together and watch TV there's no conflict he can watch his TV、dramas and you can watch the ads in between that's great okay well in the dialogue that we're going to go to now Xiao Jie was having a little bit of trouble finding CCTV 5 on her TV set CCTV 5 is the sports channel she wanted to watch some sportsWhy don't we go to back to the dialogue to take a look at that? Okay?
小杰，房间怎么样？
挺好的。照相机怎么还没有消息呢？
哈，别着急，我已经通知服务台了。有消息啊，他们马上会告诉咱们的。
以后要照顾好自己的东西啊。
看看电视节目吧，看看中国的电视节目。
有美国的电视节目吗？
我问问。你好，是前台吗？请问房间里的电视能看到美国的电视频道吗？啊，那哪个频道可以看到体育节目呢？哦，对不起，我没有找到体育频道。好，谢谢。他说上来给咱们调试一下。
哎，好，我帮你调试一下吧。
好的。
这是体育频道，这是英语频道。
哦。
哦，对了，你冰箱里还有饮料和啤酒。
So in that dialogue, we were talking about 电视 TV, but how about 电话 telephone? You ever have any problem making a call in China?
我当初我第一次打电话的时候就是日本和中国的电话打通了的时候的声音不一样而且恰恰相反所以我以为老是打不通我一打就挂下去然后试了好多次然后有一个人突然接了电话让我很吃惊
Oh, the dial tone, what we call the 铃声 the dial tone is different. So the sound you get in China, that's the busy signal.
就是不
Well, the regular tone in China is the busy signal in Japan. So you always thought the phone was busy and you hang up before the answer. Okay. How about you? Have any trouble making phone calls in China?
因为我房子里的那个电话机很破旧，所以那个杂音很厉害。
Oh, 杂音 the noise, the static. Yeah, okay.
我父母每一次给我打电话的时候，连一句话也听不清楚。
Well, you know what you can do? You can buy an IP card.And then you can dial internationally from any public phone. You can get a much better one than that 破旧 busted up old phone in your room. Okay, let's go back to the dialogue now where they're trying to figure out how to make a long distance call from the hotel. Shall we take a look?
0-4-5-6-8-7-4-2-5 通了。
喂，我是任豪啊。
任豪啊。你们怎么样？住在哪里呀？
哈，挺顺利的。我们住在明月大酒店。
啊，明月饭店离我们家不太远。行李还是没有消息？
还没有消息。
我明天想去看看你们，你们有没有时间？
哈，明天下午怎么样？
好，没问题，就这么定了。
明天晚上我们一起吃晚饭。带刘勇一起来吧，我们好多年没见了。
那好啊，你们住多少号房间？
是918房间，电话号码是总机转918房间，总机电话的号码是9645-2626。
好，我记住了，明天见。
行李还没有消息。哎，明天表姐来。
太好了，好多年没见他了。
给上海打电话。
咱们房间的电话不能打长途电话。
咱们下去问问。
好。
您好。
你好。
我们想往上海打电话，怎么办比较好？
你们可以开通您房间内电话的国内长途电话，这样您就可以在房间内直接打长途电话了。
还有别的办法吗？
你也可以买长途电话卡，这样您在公用电话上都可以打长途电话。
电话卡多少钱？
有30块、50块、100块三种。
买50块的吧。
好的，给您。
怎么打上海长途呢？
先拨上海的区号，上海的区号是021，接着拨电话号码。
谢谢。
So there are a lot of different options for making phone calls. One of the most convenient is to buy an IP card, but of course, you have to buy it with renminbi, with local currency. So you have to change money. You ever had any trouble changing money in China?
我第一次得到人民币的时候，就是觉得人民币看起来都非常像，所以我买东西的时候，有一次我把5毛钱和5块钱，付错了。
Okay, that's because many of the bills look similar. They're slightly different sizes sometimes. So you might think 5 yuan looks like 5 mao, but really that's just half of a yuan. Okay, so you have a little bit of trouble trying to figure out the difference between the bills. How about you, Kang Yunfeng? Find any trouble changing money?
其实在中国换钱很方便，好像随时随地可以换钱。而且呢，我很得意，因为欧元那么强，所以我刚来到中国的时候，我变了大手大脚，花钱如水，无论是 DVD、video、服装都买了。
Okay, because you're figuring out the price in euros, so you think you've got a lot of money. So 花钱如水 you're spending money like water. Okay, but you know, changing money in China, you can't really say it's 随时随地 because it's not everywhere. You can change in hotels, banks, some stores, but for instance, you can't change in a restaurant. So Huang Renhao and his family, when they're going out for dinner, they're going to go to a restaurant. They have to find a place to change money first. Let's see how they manage that, okay?
你好。
你好。
您办什么业务？
你好，我想用美元换人民币。
请填一下这张单子。
好的。今天的汇率是多少？
美元的卖出价是8.26。
哦。换500美元吧。
请给我看看您的护照。
哦，好。
请在这张单子上签字。
好，好的。在哪儿签呀？
右下角。这里。这是您换的人民币，您领下。
好。没问题，谢谢。
Time for a tea break. The Chinese currency, or renminbi, is not yet fully convertible. That means you can't just take renminbi in exchange, 兑换, for foreign currency without a permit or other documentation. But it's easy to change from a foreign currency into renminbi. The exchange rate is strictly regulated by the national government in China. No matter where you change money, at the airport, your hotel, a bank, or even in major shopping areas, the rate is always exactly the same. And there should be no other fees or commissions charged either. If you have Chinese currency left over at the end of your trip, you can change this back into foreign currency, provided that you've kept your original receipts from when you changed money the first time. Most people do this at the airport on their way out, as you may have to show your outbound plane ticket to prove that you are, in fact, leaving the country. Well, in today's lesson, we've been learning some really practical things, like, for instance, what are some of the things?
看电视。
看电视, watching TV. How about 办理入住手续, checking into a hotel where you'll find that your Chinese comes in really handy.
还有换钱。
换钱, changing money. And remember, don't 花钱如水, spend money like it's just water flowing. Or how about 打电话, we talked about that as well, buying an IP card, for instance. And I hope when you watch TV in the future...